If you're working from home, sometimes your employer is going to want to make sure that you're at home by locking down access to their network to your home IP address, which is a good idea security-wise. But what if you want to go spend a week visiting your parents out of town? Or what if you just want to go on a working vacation without letting your employer know? We hear about this exact situation more often than you'd expect at Rogue Support. We've had a ton of people create tickets asking us to set up VPNs into their home networks so that they can mask their actual location from their employer. And putting the ethics of that aside for a minute, I mean, I'm not one to judge how you're going to use technology. It definitely is possible. But with VPNs and even services like Tailscale or Zero Tier, there's always a danger of forgetting to enable the service before you try to connect. Or the VPN might disconnect at the wrong time and expose your actual location. So today, I'm going to show you one way that you can make that connection more solid by using GL.iNet's AstroWarp, and they are the sponsor of this video. You may know GL.iNet from their awesome travel routers that I've been reviewing here on the channel since well before they were a sponsor. GL.iNet created AstroWarp to give users a way to control where they're exiting out onto the internet without the chance of accidentally exposing their real location. In this video, we're going to first take a look at the brand new Flint 3 home router. And then we're going to get into how you can set up AstroWarp with the Flint 3 and your other GL.iNet routers to look like you've never left home, even if you have. The Flint 3 is the latest home router from GL.iNet, and it features four 2.5 gigabit LAN ports, one 2.5 gigabit WAN port, and full tri-band Wi-Fi 7 capability. This means that it can take advantage of all three consumer Wi-Fi bands, 2.4 gigahertz, 5 gigahertz, and 6 gigahertz, and you can even set up MLO or multi-link operation so that compatible Wi-Fi 7 devices like the latest smartphones can use all three of those bands simultaneously. They've also put a lot of work into this device, making sure that VPN client setup is incredibly easy. They've got pre-configured profiles for private internet access, NordVPN, Mulvad, and a bunch of others. All you have to do is log into your VPN account through the GL.iNet admin GUI, select your servers, and then connect. The Flint 3 is available now for pre-order, and you can find a link down in the description. However, as of the recording of this video, it looks like both the early bird and the super early bird pricing units are already gone. The interface of the Flint 3 should be familiar if you've ever used any of GL.iNet's travel routers. At the top of the dashboard, we've got our status indicators for WAN sources, wired and wireless LAN clients, and then which features are enabled or disabled, such as AdGuard Home, your various VPN services, and Tor. If you hover your mouse over any of the available wireless networks, you get a handy QR code that you can scan with your smartphone to connect to the Wi-Fi. They try to make everything super easy. If we click into wireless, we have the option of setting up wireless SSIDs for each one of the wireless bands independently. However, you can also choose to just set the same name SSID for any of these networks if you want to combine them together and let your devices decide which band is best. So for example, in my case, I created two separate wireless networks, one specifically for MLO that I'll be connecting my compatible Wi-Fi 7 devices to, and then I've got a separate SSD that I simply called Flint 3, and it combines the 2.4, 5, and 6 gigahertz bands together. Within each of these bands, you also have the option of enabling a guest network, which means that connected guest client devices are going to be isolated from each other for security purposes. Besides the wireless settings, the Flint 3 has all of the same capabilities that you've come to expect from GL.iNet devices, including full VPN client and server capabilities, applications such as AdGuard Home, Dynamic DNS, and parental controls built right in. We've also got a couple of cloud services. We've got Good Cloud and AstroWarp. Good Cloud is GL.iNet's central cloud controller. If you're managing a lot of these GL.iNet devices for your employees, Good Cloud lets you configure and control your routers from a single interface. And then we get to AstroWarp. So AstroWarp is similar to an SD-WAN in that it allows your routers to connect out to a central cloud network that we can control by logging into AstroWarp.net. So first you create a central network for all your devices. The one I created is called ShadowLink. And then you log into the GUI of each of your GL.iNet routers and you enable AstroWarp, you provide your AstroWarp credentials, and now you can assign your routers to that central network. You can also connect client devices directly to that same central network using a smartphone app or desktop apps for Windows or Mac. Once your devices are connected to the central network, you can create links between the devices. So, for example, if I want the Slate 7 in my remote office to connect over to the Flint 3 in this office, I can just draw a line from one to the other. Then up at the top, we can choose our exit node. I want all traffic for this whole SD-WAN network to flow through this Flint 3 no matter which router I'm connected to. So I'm going to pick the Flint 3 and then I'm going to toggle on my other router, the Slate 7, and click Apply. When you click the connector between the Slate 7 and the Flint 3, you can now see a new toggle button that says Access the Internet via Flint 3. And as long as you've configured AstroWarp to do this, anywhere you plug in that Slate 7 or any of their travel routers, it's going to automatically use the Flint 3 as its exit node, and there's no chance of that accidentally not working. So now just connect your devices to the Slate 7 with wires or through Wi-Fi, and you will appear as if you're connecting from your home office. So let's now test this out. I've got the Flint 3 connected to my Comcast business internet here at my home office. I'm connected to Wi-Fi with my iPhone, and if I go to whatismyip.com, I can see that I'm in Oregon and that my ISP is Comcast Cable with an IP address ending in 30. I'm now sitting at the Crosstalk remote office, remote studio, and what I've got set up here is the GL.iNet Slate 7 travel router plugged in using T-Mobile home internet as its WAN connection. And if we look at my screen here, right now we can see that I'm using that T-Mobile connection because I have not enabled the Slate 7 to connect through AstroWarp and use the Flint 3 as its exit node for the internet. So let's do that now. In AstroWarp, I just click the connection between the Slate 7 and the Flint 3, and I toggle this on right here that says Access the Internet via Flint 3, and that's all we have to do. If I go back to what is my IP address, and we hit refresh, it now detects that I am using Comcast Cable with that same IP address ending in .30. And now I am at an undisclosed hotel location, undisclosed because it doesn't matter. This could be anywhere in the world. And I have my Slate 7 once again. This time I don't have any Ethernet because I couldn't find a connection here in the hotel room. So I am connected using Wi-Fi as WAN, or what's known as repeater mode in the GL.iNet travel router. When I left my remote office, AstroWarp was still configured to use the Flint 3 at my home office for its exit node. So now I've plugged this Slate 7 into a completely different WAN source, and yet I am still seeing my Comcast cable connection with IP address ending in .30 when I go to whatismyip.com. So everything is working perfectly. And that's the whole point of AstroWarp. No matter where you are, you can appear as if you're hitting the internet from wherever you set the exit node, and that's not gonna change from place to place. So I'm not one to judge. Go ahead and fly to Hawaii to get your work done, but you do wanna remember to set your Zoom background accordingly. I hope this has been helpful to you, and thanks again to GL.iNet for sponsoring this video. And if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my ultimate RV internet setup, and the bottom video is my full comparison of Starlink versus 5G home internet.